Hello friends, so today we are going to learn about what is DLL and how to implement it using Visual Studio 6.0. So first step is what is DLL? So DLL is the concept used by Microsoft by which how it implements shared library of operating systems. So just see the screen. Suppose this is an application created for the end user, and this is DLL. What is actually DLL? So suppose if there is a vendor who creates a code for some calculator, but it does not want to share this code with the end user or the another company. So we can do this with the dynamic link libraries. So the vendor will only share this DLL file to that application maker, so he can implement the functions of the that calculator but not sharing the actual code. So this could be very helpful if you want to get the secrecy of your code, of because your code can be very optimized or something like that. So after that, another use of DLL is that it is used to reduce memory overhead. So when several applications are running, they share the same DLL code, although each application has different DLL data. DLL data in the sense the arguments, whereas DLL code are the functions, so they are same. So this is the place where DLL is used. This reduces the memory overhead by a lot. So you would have often seen this DLL file in many games. Almost every game uses this concept DLL. So next we'll see how to implement it. So we're gonna implement one scientific calculator using DLL. So first go to start menu. Then click on this Microsoft Visual Studio 6.0, then Microsoft Visual C++ 6.0. Now here you see this screen. Now click on File, New. Now here under the Project tab, you can see Win32 Dynamic Link Library. Click on that. Now give a project name. Suppose I am giving a project name DLL to somewhat like that. You can change the location by here. Suppose I want to save it in D, then save it and click OK. Then again click OK. Now in this dialog box, select a simple DLL project checkbox, then finish. Then OK. Now at the left hand corner you can see two views, class view and the file view. Now click on the file view. Now under this workspace DLL2 one project, click on the DLL2 files. Now source files, then DLL2.cpp. Now this code is automatic generated. Now what we do here is we actually write the functions we want in our application. So I have already suppose I am copying this function. We want to add two numbers, so this is the function for it. We'll just copy it here. You can write it, you can implement whatever function you want, addition, subtraction, multiplication, mod, any scientific function. So if you are implementing any mathematical function of C, so what do? We include hashtag include maths.h. Like this. Okay. After this, when we are done with this, will now here you can see double. This is the return type. This is the function name add one. Double x means the first argument and its data type. This returning x plus y. Now here you can see underscore std call. So what does it tell? So it is used to tell that how to allocate this stacks and the arguments for that. So it basically guides for stack allocation. This is a standard function call exactly. So after that, then again click on file, new, then in this file tab click on the text file. Don't change anything here, just type the name dll2.def. this is the definition file. Then click OK. So in this we are gonna copy the contents first. Okay, so here you can see the first line. What does it say? Library calc. So library, it means that this definition file belongs to a DLL file. It tests that. Calc is the name of the DLL file. You can give it anything here. Yeah. It depends on you. Exports is used to export the contents of the DLL, that is the functions, to the other applications. Then these are the function name. Add one, sub one. Here you can see there is add one function. You have to write this same name in the definition file. And beside this, you can see at this after space at the rate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what are these? These are actually the ordinals. These are actually the ordinals which are used to give a specific naming to the functions, so they can be called easily. After this, click on build, then again click on rebuild all. Now here, as we have not copied all the function in this, and we declared many things like sub1, mul1 and div1, many things in this. So we have to also declare the function in the CPP. So we have already earlier copied only one of those. So we are gonna copy all of these codes here. Copy and paste. Now we will rebuild again. Now there are zero errors in the warning. We can neglect it, so there are actually no errors. After this, we are done. So after we rebuild all, and one more thing, if you do anything here, if you change the name or the function or the contents of that, you have to again rebuild all and everything. Now after this, go to the location where you have actually created the project, -axg-dll2. Now go to debug, and this is the file dll2.dll. Our DLL file is created now. So after this, our main work is done. Our DLL file is created, so our process is right until now. Now the next step is again go to start menu and go to Microsoft Visual Studio 6.0. Then earlier we used Microsoft Visual C++ 6.0. Now we will use Microsoft Visual Basic 6.0. This is the dialog box we are getting. Now click open. Now you can do it. So this is the form. And what do we do in form? We design the interface, what we are going to do in the application. So here we are implementing a scientific calculator for that. So we will design the interface for that. So this is the text box. This is used to get the input and output. This is the text 1, text 2, and this is text 3. Okay, now this is A. This is the label. So what are you going to give in the label? We should change the caption. First number. Now one more layer for this. Second number. Gonna do it a little bit. And the last one. This is the result. After this, this is the command box. We click on it. This is used to give the functions. So we are first implementing addition function. So we'll change the caption of this, that is addition button. Okay. Now this, here we can see it is showing text 1, text 2, text 3. We don't want to show all this to the user, so we should edit this also. Here we can just clear it all. And similarly for this. Now we want to add the functions to the button. Now just double click on this. This we can just delete it. So we will get something like this. These codes are automatic generated. Private sub command and click. Now under this we are gonna write what does this do, what this command button do. This as you know, this is a text 1, this is text box 2, this is text box 3. So for example, this is the code. This is what we're gonna copy in this. What does this says? This is the text box 3. So this will show the output. Now what is the function we are gonna use? Add one. This is the function we used in the DLL file. This is the val text 1.text, comma val text 2.text. This is the first argument, this is the second argument for that. And the result will be displayed in the text box 3. Now one more thing we have to do. Earlier we used this in def file, we have seen this exports. This exports all the functions to the application we are using. Okay, so after this we want to import these all functions into this file, in this program. So we are gonna use this statement. Just copy it above. Private declare function, add one library, and the location of this DLL. So what is the location of this DLL2? We're just gonna get the location. We're just gonna get the location from this and copy it here. DLL2.dll. Okay. Now this we can see by val x as double. By val, what does this signify is the arguments which we are passing should not be changed in the DLL. So DLL cannot, the functions in the DLL cannot change these arguments by any means. And what this means as double, it returns value in double format. Okay, so after this we are done. So this is the basic. Now we'll just close it. So here is, you can see two buttons. Like if this click this one, we'll get the source code dialog box. If we click this one, we'll get this form. Now what do we have to do? We will have to run it. Wait. We have to run it. 85. See, this we have implemented the addition function. 85 plus 25 equals 110. So this was a simple program. Now we will see the scientific calculator. I have already made it. So let's close it everything. Now this is the scientific calculator. As I have discussed earlier, this is the number 1, number 2, result, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, everything, whatever is in there. So now we see the source code for this. I have now we can see I have, for each of the function you have to individually import it, all these libraries, and pass that arguments into that. Okay, so this is a command 1, click command 10, square root. This is the function we implemented in the DLL file. It only holds one variable. And similarly, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Now here, as we can see, log, sine, and cos 10. So we do not need to implement a function in the DLL because it is already implemented by default in this Visual Basic. So we should just type log with L capital, sine, cos, and 10. Everything will be already implemented in this. And this was the earlier program, DLL or CPP. This is the F mod. If you are using mod, we need to. This is the DLL CPP which we have implemented in this VC++. This one. Okay. So here, as we can see, if you want to implement mod function, then we need to this already, it is already defined in the C++ match.h header file, so we can just directly use it. Similarly, power and square root. Now we'll run it. This is the, now we'll just do a checking. 25 divided by 5, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Now log x, this is log x to the base to the power e. This will do the log of 25, well, only of the first number. Similarly, sin x, cos x, tan x, mod xy, it gives, yields the remainder. Suppose I am writing here 3, then we will get a remainder of 1. This is root x, result is 5, 25 root 5, and x to the power y, 15625. So this is the all I can tell. Thank you.